Thanks for swinging by for the storm update. I'm meteorologist John Hickey. Of course, all eyes are going on to what's happening later on this afternoon and into the first part of your Sunday. Bottom line, it's going to be a mess. We're going to have the entire kitchen sink thrown at us with some snow, some ice, some rain, and some wind into the mix, too. Highest impacts from the storm will be tonight into the early hours of Sunday morning before this thing changes over to just some plain rainfall as temperatures warm up into the 40s on Sunday. Biggest icing concerns I have at this time likely across eastern Vermont and into portions of the Upper Valley. Just want to go over some semantics with you. A winter storm warning, generally eastern Green Mountains, Northeast Kingdom, up and down the Upper Valley as well. In the immediate Champlain Valley and for the rest of northern New York, looking at winter weather advisories. Long story short, less icing and snow in the Champlain Valley, more icing, more snow as you head over towards the Northeast Kingdom as well as portions of the Upper Valley. So we're going to step through Futurecast here just a couple of hours at a time because conditions will be quite changeable. In the morning on Saturday, things were okay, just some thickening cloud cover, so any little peaks of sunshine that we have will occur very early on. But later on this afternoon, we start to track that snow from southwest moving to the northeast. By 3 o'clock, maybe a flurry, but thinking we wait until closer to dinner time before we start to find some snow. Can't stress it enough, this thing starts as snow for everybody, and it will come down fast and furious for a time, too. Highest snow impacts coming our way between, I'd say, 7 and 11 tonight. That's when we'll find some snowfall rates approaching about an inch an hour. That's tough to keep up with, so roads quickly become snow-covered, slow going. So if you have evening plans tonight, either allow yourself a ton of extra time or maybe just wait until Sunday to get some of that stuff done because road conditions will certainly be quite messy. Going in closer to midnight, we'll watch as that mix line starts to move off to the northeast, likely starting to find some mix in the Champlain Valley. Even out in the Adirondacks, too, looks like Northeast Kingdom and Upper Valley last to change over to some of that icing or even just some plain rainfall. That likely occurs by first thing Sunday morning, and then during the day Sunday, I think what we find is mainly just some rain, as temperatures will be well into the 40s by that point. But that icing concern, likely in that, what I like to call, deadly triangle from about St. Johnsbury, cross Route 2 to Montpelier, and down to Lebanon, we're going to have a southeasterly wind, and that area is very sheltered from a southeasterly wind. So you folks, I'd be concerned with over of a quarter of an inch of icing, in addition to some of the highest snowfall amounts. So it's not to say that all of us couldn't see some scattered power outages, but I think it's going to be in that triangle there that has the greatest chance of seeing some of that. Now, beyond Sunday, we're going to see a very cold blast of air come our way, and it's going to last all week long, arrives on some snow showers, perhaps, before Monday morning. So here's the bottom line in terms of snow. About 2 to 4 inches, there's going to be a lot of compacting with this mix and rain that's expected. Generally, just a little bit more for the Adirondacks as well as the Northeast Kingdom. Wouldn't be surprised if there were some surprises out here close to 7 or 8 inches. But again, with the mix and rain coming, that'll quickly compact down. And I'm thinking that it's going to be the heavy, wet nature of what's falling combined with the wind that'll be of greatest concern. 5-day plus 2 forecast beyond the storm. Look at that. I mean, 44 degrees tomorrow. We go down to 20 on Monday, and then we hang out in the teens. And I'll tell you now, Wednesday night and Thursday, these numbers might not be doing it justice. I think portions of the Northeast Kingdom and the Adirondacks probably in the 20s below zero Wednesday night. And then on Thursday, we may even only get into the single digits in the warm spot. So that's likely the coldest of the cold, and then temperatures perhaps slowly warming as we take you into next weekend. Stay tuned on air and online for WPTC's updates on the storm. I'm meteorologist John Hickey. Stay safe and have a great day.